Good morning, YouTube. I am right now I am drinking some coffee, eating some breakfast, which includes rye toast and a banana, and currently I'm watching Lost in Space, and nobody else likes to watch it except for me, so I have to watch it when I'm by myself, and I'm finally at home, which is also a rarity in my life. So I'm doing laundry, but I'm trying to keep myself, like, pretty, excuse me, pretty focused, as I am right now, and committed to getting ready and going to the gym, because I've been, to be honest, I've been struggling going consistently due to school and things like that. I've just been exhausted. Work is very draining, very rewarding, but very draining. And then going to school, you know, 4 days a week, also very draining. So trying to stay focused now that school's over for at least a month and go consistently. Bobby and I are going on vacation at the end of May, so I don't know. Thought I would just do a little bit of a vlog, a little bit of a vlogging, maybe like a little bit of a get ready with me or something. I don't know. It's hard for me to do a whole lot of videos just because I don't know how it affects my career. Obviously, I can't get too personal on here. But I do really enjoy YouTube, and I do enjoy having a teeny tiny itty bitty baby platform to maybe speak some truth into some people's lives, and hopefully, having it more focused on mental health once I have, like, a solid understanding of everything and have my license and things like that. So, yeah, I don't know, I guess. When I'm done watching this episode, I'll go take a shower, then you can, like, watch me get ready. It's really not that exciting, but it's better than nothing, so. See ya in a few. Hello, little cuties. So, I just got done showering. I did get lazy, to be honest, and took me forever to, like, get my butt in gear, but I showered, and now it's time to pick an outfit. My closet is a disaster, so I also have, like, clothes that hang over there that I usually wear, that I like to wear, like, throughout the week. I keep them over there, and then I hang wet clothes over there, too, so, but this is my workout collection closet. I need to get rid of some things, to be honest, but, like, I have all of these leggings, tank tops, crop tops, long sleeve and t-shirt, and then jackets, like my Lululemon jacket. So today, I think that I will go with, let's see, maybe these puppies? I haven't worn these in a while, though. I try really hard to, like, wear a good amount of my outfits because I don't want to keep re-wearing the same thing over and over. But it can get difficult. So yeah, let's see. There's that. And then I have a bunch of shoes up here and my camera case. And then I have jackets over there. And then a bunch of shoes down there and more shoes over there. And then I put a little light in here earlier because it's cute and makes it easier to see. That'll be my outfit for the gym, and probably for the day because I don't like to change after that because then I just have loads of laundry to do. I am going to put some lotion on. I always put this on my tattoos, and then whatever Bath & Body Works lotion for the rest of my body. I have some pretty intense breakouts on my chin, So I use this Proactive MD. But it happens, and I have to put that over. And then to moisturize, I use the Murad Pore Rescue Balancing Moisturizing, blah, blah, blah. Because the other one I had was from the same company, was like dry, and it didn't leave my skin glowy, and I don't like that. I do not like that. And then some deodorant. And, oh, I've been putting this stuff in my hair because I've noticed that it's... What? This stuff in my hair from Body Shop, because I've been noticing that it's been, just struggling. My hair's been dry and not soft, and I haven't liked that, so, alright, but my face is starting to dry out. I hate that feeling, so I'm gonna start getting ready, and then once I'm dressed, I'll pop back over and say hello. I've been moving kind of slow, no trouble with me. Trying to keep it peaceful is a struggle for me. Don't pull up at 6 a.m. and cuddle with me. You know how I like it when you loving on me. I don't wanna die for them to miss me. Guess I see the things that they wishing on me. Hope I got some brothers that outlive me. Ain't gon' tell the story, shit was different with me. God's plan, God's plan. I hold back, sometimes I won't, ay. I feel good when I'm alone, ay. Leave me in the studio, ay, wait. Daily self-discovery, yeah, ay. Holiday recovery, wait, ay. They love them instead of me. And still, bad days, there's a lot of bad days. They wish, and they wish, and they wish, and they wish, and they wish. Say, do you love me? I tell her only partly. I only love my cat and my snowboard, I'm sorry. 93, I even got it tatted on me. 2012, lady, y'all not feeling sorry. And you know me, without teeter probably would be no me, dog. Holler back at me in 2023. Lying bitches up from the nosebleeds, yeah. God's plan, God's plan. I can't do this on my own. Here's to me and Team Thoreau, yeah. Holding down Colorado. Staying true to 303, yeah. I hope one day Drake see me, yeah. Summer dropping my EP. And still, bad days, there's a lot of bad days. They wish, and they wish, and they wish, and they wish, and they wish. I've been moving kind of slow, no trouble with me. Trying to keep it peaceful is a struggle for me. Don't pull up at 6 a.m. and cuddle with me. You know how I like it when you loving on me. I don't wanna die for them to miss me. Guess I see the things that they wishing on me.
Okay,
So, just still watching this show. I think once this episode's over, I'm gonna get in the car and go to the gym, and I will bring you with me and do my best to film my workout. I'm not doing lower body today, so it might be, I'm gonna do shoulders, and maybe a little bit of abs. I don't know. But I will just try and bring you with me. And I feel like I have some type of fear about filming at the gym. I don't know why. Who cares? But whatever. So, why don't I do a little bit of blabbing about myself so that people can get to know me a little bit. So currently I am studying to become a clinical mental health counselor at Kent State. And I feel like I've said this before, but I kind of want this channel to eventually turn into some type of education about mental health. But I guess for right now I can just explain the counseling experience. So I just got done with my first practicum, which is basically practice at Kent State, and they don't let you do it anywhere else but the counseling center there. And unfortunately, a lot of people don't even know that we have a free counseling center. We do. It's awesome. I would suggest going, even if you don't have like a typical problem or something. You know, I think counseling is good for everyone's mental health. I am, to be honest, confused about what's going on recently with, you know, the way that people view counseling and, oh, it's not a lifetime thing, blah, blah, blah. But in the back of my head, I'm like, why wouldn't it be? Like, I get if you're becoming really reliant on your counselor and you can't figure out life things without them. But at the same time, even if you were just going to just check in with someone and say, you know, this is what I've been going through, just wanted to let you know, I feel like I'm still doing really well. I did X, Y, and Z using these coping skills, blah, blah, blah. And just having someone as support, like maybe twice a month or once a month. I don't think there's anything wrong with that. But right now, what I'm learning is that counseling is like very time limited. So once we have a treatment plan, which basically explains what's going on with the client and what they need help with, you have a certain amount of time to get that done. And it seems like if they have another goal in mind after that goal is accomplished within that time limit, counseling can continue. But I don't know. I feel like there's so much going on with insurance if they're not like, oh yeah, we understand and we'll keep paying for this person to go to counseling because we see that they have a legitimate real problem and they need to keep going. I just don't know. I don't know. I feel like they would just say, we're not gonna keep paying for this, which doesn't seem right to me. I could see both sides. Like, I would never want my clients to be like, oh, I can't live without Autumn. I can't figure out my life without her. I want them to obviously be able to be okay with or without me, but just having a safe space for them to come in and check in and things like that, I think is relevant as well. But anyway, so far I finished my practicum and I had 5 clients that I saw consistently. It was a very eye-opening experience. There are so many things that I feel like I don't know. Like, when I first started, I was very gung-ho on, like, let me fix everybody's problems. And let me just, you know, give you this and you leave and you make everything better, you know, kind of thing. And slowly but surely, I realized that's not really what counseling is about. It's more so listening, helping them understand their point of view from different angles, connecting with someone and also giving some type of modeling. I don't know if I've necessarily learned modeling well yet, just because, like, I'm sitting in a box with someone, what could I possibly model? But I guess remaining calm, having some type of understanding of myself and trust in myself that I can kind of, like, give off this confidence to someone so that they can see it and bring it into their own life. I don't know. I'm also pretty bad at, like, reflecting things to people. That was one of the things that I said I really wanted to work on for next practicum, because I'm hearing what my clients are saying, but I feel like I don't know if I'm nervous or what, but I usually say it back in some weird way, and I'm like, how does that make sense? Like, when I rewatch the tapes, I'm like, how do they say, yeah, that's exactly what I said? I'm like, are you sure? But yeah, so I just feel like I need to get a better grasp on certain diagnoses. We don't diagnose at the counseling center, but I mean, in general, it's good to know in the back of your head, if this person was to be diagnosed, what would they be diagnosed with? And things that I feel like I'm really going to struggle with are eating disorders, suicide, severe depression, just because I'm not quite sure how to help these people yet. I haven't gotten my grips around it. I haven't studied it enough. And like in the back of my head, I feel that to overcome depression, like, there's this thing called CBT, which is a type of counseling, and it's kind of like changing your thought processes and your perspectives on what's going on in your life. And at first I thought that was kind of bull. I was like, oh, you think you're just gonna change some your thoughts and everything's gonna be okay? But then when I think about how I live my life, when I met Bobby, I had the opportunity to choose how I was going to be in that relationship. So basically, am I going to be angry with him over little things? Am I going to be upset over little things? Or am I just going to get through it and talk like an adult and whatever else? So, I was choosing to not live this relationship like I had lived others, and to also, I was also choosing not to be angry or upset over things that I felt like, okay, I could be angry about this because it was stupid on Bobby's part or my friend's part or my grandparents' part, or I could get over it and just move on. I'm not saying buckle and accept, you know, people treating you poorly. I'm just saying, fight your battles. You know, is it worth being upset and angry and depressed when who knows what's going to happen tomorrow to those people or yourself? And to me, it's just not worth it. It's not worth ever being upset at Bobby, because he's worth more to me than anything else. So, you know, I'll be upset for a minute and then I'll tell him, you know, it's really not worth the argument. I just want you to know how I feel, and please don't, you know, do that again. And I hope he feels the same way, and I hope he talks to me the same way, because obviously I never want to be hurt and I never want to hurt him, but, you know, I don't want to spend our relationship being mad at each other. Not even one day. Not even one day do I want to waste on being angry with Bobby or my friends or my family. It's just like, just figure out a way to change your perspective and your thought process and be assertive and firm, but don't be stuck. Don't let things rule the way that you live your life. Don't be so bullheaded that you can't see other people's perspectives. So yeah, I guess when it comes to learning about depression and eating disorders, I have to figure out how to apply that type of counseling, but also to understand that people probably aren't necessarily there most of their lives. Maybe they don't know how to do that, or maybe they don't want to do that. And I think the biggest problem that I struggle with is that I want to fix things for other people, and you can't do that. That's not what counseling is about. It's helping them fix their own problems, but they have to want to. They have to want to change. They have to accept the learning techniques and counseling techniques given, and then apply them. And that's hard for me, because I feel like I really just want to fix what's happening with my clients right then and there for them, because I care so much, and that's not how it works. So I think that's something that I need to learn how to do. I also feel like I'm still struggling with the taking stuff home with me. So that's a big part of counseling is, you know, you don't want to take home what your clients share with you, because it can be detrimental to your mental health and to your life and what's going on in your life. If you're totally focused on somebody else's life or a bunch of other people's lives, how are you supposed to, you know, live your own? So, So I think those are the main things right now that I'm struggling with. I'm trying to get better with counseling. And to be honest, I think that everybody should seek counseling no matter what. I feel like everybody's gone through something that they could use counseling for to really get through it, or figure out how to deal with it next time, or just to talk to someone. I feel like I need to get my own counseling sometime just to really understand what my clients are going through when they come into my office. I want to see it from their perspective, which would be getting my own counseling, and then also making sure that I'm a healed person from my own trauma in my own life, so that I can make sure that I am the best that I can be for my clients. So it'll happen one day when I feel like I can breathe air and I'm not in school 24/7. I'll get there. But for now, I just want to work on those things and start being a better counselor. I'm excited for where this road will take me, and I feel like I'm on the right path, just because, you know, I do have such a giant heart and soul for these things. I do leave pieces of myself with everybody that I meet in this field, whether it be at work or at school. And I don't think there's anything wrong with that, as long as I'm, you know, controlling, like I said, what I take home with me and how I handle things and how I take care of myself, because I have to be the best that I can be every day, you know, so I have to make sure I'm really taking care of myself. I was made for this, and I want to keep doing it, and I think that I can really make a difference in people's lives. So, but that's just a little bit about what I'm doing right now with my life, and, you know, why I go to school and why I'm so stressed and why it's so hard for me to vlog, because I do a lot of the same things every day, and a lot of the stuff that I do is confidential, you know, everything that I do with my clients is confidential, so I won't be sharing any of that information. But I really appreciate having a YouTube page, just because I feel like one day, if it was big enough, I could give help to more people than just a few that I see in my office, if that makes sense. I don't know how or when or what it's gonna look like, but I think that's why I want to have a YouTube page. We'll see what happens. For now, I'm just gonna stick to favorites and blogging, vacations, and gym stuff, and hauls, and whatever else, because those are things that I love too. I'm figuring out how to get my bearings on YouTube and what I need to do from here on out. So, all right, but I just wanted to share that. I'm gonna get going and go to the gym so I don't tucker myself out too much. Okay, I'll see you there, maybe.
and the downs of me. Got a whole lot of love, but you don't wanna spread around with me. Yeah, never pick up, never call me. You know we're running out of time. Never pick up when you want me. Now I gotta draw a line. Baby, I done done enough talking. Need to know that you're mine. Baby, we done done enough talking. Gotta be right now, right now. Baby, gon' love me now.
Best workout in the world because I was filming, but it was nice to get a good film in. I haven't done that in a really long time actually, so I hope you guys enjoyed it. I got over my fear kind of, so I can't. My glasses eat my hair and I'm over it. Anyways, so I got over my fear kind of. I filmed, but I stayed in the corner, so I just brought everything to me. Right now I'm gonna go get some clothes, even though I shouldn't, but I just want one item. See if I can get myself there. And it's raining, and it's annoying because it keeps getting harder and softer and harder and softer, and my hair is gonna be ruined, so. Alright. Bye. Needless to say, I did not buy one thing. I bought a few, but TJ Maxx, to be fair, is cheap. So I got this lovely guy. from 90 Degree. It retails for like $100 and at TJ Maxx it's 25. So it's basically like the one that I'm wearing that you saw like in a couple of my workouts that I warm up in and stuff like that. And I thought this color was really beautiful. I got a new sports bra. No promises that this is going to fit me because I didn't try it on. It's Under Armour. Size medium. Retails for $30. Got it for $12. So I think it's very beautiful and very bright and would look nice under some things. I got another raincoat just because I always wear this one. So I thought, why not mix it up a little bit. It's New Balance. I really like the color. That's really all I looked at. I was like, wow, that's so cool and shiny and weirdly, gosh, what's that word? Not opal. Iridescent. So it has like that, a little bit of like iridescence in it. Like, I don't know if you guys can see it, but it's a little bit green. Don't know what it retails for, but it, oh, okay. It retails for $32. Got it for $25. So not that great of a deal, but better than $32. And then I got these Pumas. So freaking cute. Retails for $50. Got them for $39.99. So basically $40. And they're 7.5. Super cute. They have lots of pairs. So if you live around a TJ Maxx, I would suggest going. They have so many good brands, to be honest, like Puma, Nike, Michael Kors, on and on and on. Obviously, 90 Degree, like that stuff is expensive and they have it there too. So totally worth a trip if you live by one. If you don't, you should probably move by one. But yeah, I don't know. Just, I had a good time shopping and I didn't spend that much money, which is nice. All right, I'll see you when I get home. Actually, Chipotle. I've arrived at this idiot's house. He likes to mess up his beautiful hair with this freaking ugly hat. Babe, fix it. You look like a goof. Outfit for the night. I got my Fashion Nova jeans on. And this top is from American Eagle, and this jacket is from a random website. And who knows what Bobby's wearing? Same old crap that he always wears. Now he looks cute. Mm-hmm. It's been a long, hard day, and I'm just not willing to do anything, and he wants to go hang out with his stupid friend, so we'll see how that goes. But in other news, I look adorable. Adorable.